So you had P is equal to 1 by 3 M by V C square, where we said that C square is C1 square plus C2 square, so on up to Cn square over N, where this was C. Okay. So that means C is equal to under the root C1 square plus C2 square, so on up to Cn square. So you can see that what is C here, this is RMS speed of gas molecule, because C is root of mean of squares of individual velocities of gas molecules. So that is why C is called RMS speed of gas molecules. So RMS stands for root mean square. So this part was left, that pressure exerted by a gas, that means the pressure with which the molecules hit the bottom of the container, the walls of the container, that is given by 1 by 3 M by V C square. We can also call it P is 1 by 3 rho C square, where rho is density, mass upon volume. Okay, so we can also call it density. Density is mass over volume. This is our expression. Okay, fine. Let us define absolute zero of temperature. Absolute zero of temperature means zero Kelvin. What do we mean by zero Kelvin? Zero Kelvin is called absolute zero of temperature. I told you the postulates of kinetic energy, kinetic theory of gases, and I told you that kinetic energy is directly proportional to temperature. Last postulate, the main postulate was kinetic energy of gas is directly proportional to absolute temperature of the gas, right? So this kinetic energy is half mc square, we can write, or you can say c square is directly proportional to T. Mainly this outcome we are having. And if temperature is absolute zero, then this RMS speed also becomes zero. So this is how we can define absolute zero of temperature. It is the temperature at which molecular motion ceases, stops. It is the temperature at which molecular motion ceases. Write down the definition of absolute zero of temperature. Write down the definition of absolute zero of temperature. It is the temperature at which the molecular motion ceases, stops. It is the temperature at which the molecular motion ceases. जहाँ पे molecules इतने inactive हो जाते हैं, बिल्कुल ही वो move करना ही बंद कर देते हैं. So it is practically impossible to achieve. Practically, absolute zero of temperature is impossible to achieve. Now, let us define degrees of freedom. Degrees of freedom. To specify the state of a gas, we need some coordinates. Those coordinates are called degrees of freedom, right? So, likhiye definition, degrees of freedom. Degrees of freedom. Denoted by F. Write down the definition of degrees of freedom. It's the number of independent coordinates. It is the number of independent coordinates required. Number of independent coordinates required to specify the state of a gas. You know the equation of state of a gas, PV is equal to nRT, you already know that. PV is equal to nRT is the equation of a gas, and the variables that are specifying this equation that are PVT, main variables are pressure, volume and temperature. So number of independent coordinates required to specify the state of a gas are called degrees of freedom. Let us calculate the degrees of freedom for different types of gases. Okay, first of all, the basic formula is 3N minus R. Note down the basic formula for calculating degrees of freedom, where N is number of members of the system. Or if we are taking a molecule, then number of atoms, we mean to say. Number of members means number of atoms. And R is the relations, number of relations existing among those members. R means relations. Let us take up a monatomic gas, first of all. For a monatomic, mono means single atom. So number of atoms is one in such a gas. So we are taking a monatomic gas, first of all. For example, noble gases you can take, helium is there, neon is there, xenon is there. These are monatomic gases. Okay, examples of monatomic gases are helium, neon, xenon, etc. So in this case, number of atoms is one. And if there is only one member of the system, how can be there any relation existing? Number of relations existing must be zero. So no relation is existing because there is only one member. So put in the formula now. 3 into 1 minus 0, 3 degrees of freedom. So that means for a monatomic gas, there are 3 degrees of freedom. There are 3 degrees of freedom for a monatomic gas. Secondly, let us take a diatomic gas. Di means 2. So there are 2 members in this system. N is 2 here. Examples of monatomic gases: hydrogen, nitrogen, chlorine, etc. So there are 2 atoms. Carbon monoxide you can take. Okay, and what is the structure? How many relations are existing? Oxygen is also there. For example, oxygen is there. So this is the kind of structure of oxygen. How many relations, how many bonds are there? There is only one bond. Ye nahi dekhna ki double bond hai, triple bond hai. Bond means relation. So there is only one relation possible between two members. So relation is one. Number of relations is one. Put in these values in again the formula. So F is equal to 3 into 2 minus 1. 6 minus 1, 5. So for a diatomic gas, degrees of freedom, number of degrees of freedom is 5. Okay, there are 5 degrees of freedom. Okay, clear? So the question can be like this. Calculate the degrees of freedom for fluorine gas. So you have to identify yourself that it is diatomic. So then you should go for this. Thirdly, let us take triatomic gas, but the structure of triatomic molecules can be linear also, non-linear also. So we have to consider both the cases. Third case, linear triatomic gas. Let's take up an example of linear triatomic gas. For example, carbon dioxide. There are 3 atoms, 1 carbon atom, 2 oxygen atoms. Okay, so this is linear triatomic. The structure of carbon dioxide is linear, you know, this kind of structure. That's why it is linear triatomic molecule. How many relations? So members, number of members of the system is obviously 3. How many relations? How many bonds are there? There are 2 relations. There can be 2 relations between 3 members. So let's put in the values. F is 3 into 3 minus 2. 9 minus 2, 7. So that would be 7. 7 degrees of freedom for linear triatomics. Is that clear? Then, non-linear triatomic gas. Non-linear Can you give me an example of non-linear triatomic gas? For example, water molecule. Okay, steam. Steam is also a gas, right? So let us take water molecule as an example of non-linear triatomic gas. Okay, let us take water molecule, H2O. Its structure is non-linear, you all know. Its structure is non-linear. How we can write that? This type of structure. This is non-linear structure. So number of members of the system is 3 and number of relations can also be 3. How 3? It is not necessary that there should be a bond here. Means can be. Yes. Okay, so number of relations is 3, number of members is also 3. You will say that there are only 2 bonds, but there can be a bond here also. So we will say that R is also 3. Number of relations can be 3 maximum. So put in the formula, what do you get? F is equal to 3 minus 3, 6. So there are 6 degrees of freedom. Okay, so have a look at all these guesses, and if any calculation of F is not clear to you, you can ask. You can raise your hand. Yes, Kavya.
I'm not only dear.
We had calculation of gamma also, but that is not in the syllabus. But I will be telling you about the gamma and a shortcut formula so that you can calculate that. Okay? So after degrees of freedom, we have gamma. What is gamma? I told you it is the ratio of 2 principal specific heats, Cp and Cv. Cp is specific heat, molar specific heat at constant pressure of the gas, and Cv is molar specific heat at constant volume. I tell you, Cp is molar specific heat at constant pressure. And Cv is molar specific heat at constant volume. Cp and Cv. This is the meaning. Now, how do we define CP and CV? Who will tell me what is simple specific heat? अभी तक आपने जो ninth में पढ़ी है, specific heat होती क्या? Who will tell me? Yes, what is specific heat? कौन बताएगा? Specific heat. For example, water is having very high specific heat, 4.2 joule per gram per degree Celsius. Okay, water की specific heat काफी ज़्यादा है. So that's why water is a storehouse of energy. It's used mainly for heating and cooling purposes. तो specific heat आपको याद है क्या होती थी? It is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass of substance through 1 degree Celsius. तो जब हम 1 kg सब्सटेंस का जो टेम्परेचर है 1 degree सेल्सियस के थ्रू रेज करते हैं, द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट रिक्वायर्ड टू डू सो दैट इज कॉल्ड स्पेसिफिक हीट. वो सिंपल स्पेसिफिक हीट थी जब हम 1 kg या 1 gram लेते थे सब्सटेंस का, और उसका 1 degree सेल्सियस इंक्रीज होने में जितनी हीट हमें देनी पड़ती है दैट इज कॉल्ड स्पेसिफिक हीट. मोलर स्पेसिफिक हीट सेम वे is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 mole of a gas. By the name it is clear. Molar means 1 mole. So amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 mole of a gas by 1 degree Celsius. Likh lo definition. Molar specific heat kya hoti hai? It is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 mole of a gas by 1 degree Celsius. Amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 mole of a gas by 1 degree Celsius. That is called molar specific heat. And when we are considering the gas at constant volume, that is called molar specific heat at constant volume, CV. And when we take the conditions of constant pressure, then we call that CP. Bas, yehi hai. Chemistry mein bhi you must have read that CP is greater than CV. More heat is required at constant pressure than at constant volume. We will also be proving later on. Don't worry. Heat and thermodynamics में हम ये derive भी करेंगे that CP is greater than CV. By now you see that gamma क्या होता है? Gamma is the ratio of these two principal specific heats. These are also called principal specific heats or molar specific heats. So CP by CV. अब इसका पहले पूरा वो syllabus में था calculation of gamma, like the way we have calculated degrees of freedom, same way we had calculation of gamma also, but now it's not in the syllabus. So I'll be telling a relationship between degrees of freedom and gamma. With the help of that, you can calculate. Okay, that relation is gamma is 1 plus 2 by f, where you know f is number of degrees of freedom. So let us calculate it for monatomic gas. First of all, let's calculate it for a monatomic gas. How many degrees of freedom we just calculated? 3 degrees of freedom. So what is gamma for monatomic gas? 5 by 3. So gamma for monatomic gas, this way you can calculate gamma for all the gases. Okay, now solve this for diatomic gas. Tell me what is the answer. For diatomic gas there are 5 degrees of freedom. There are 5 degrees of freedom. So what is gamma? Raise hand if you have solved. Yes, Samriddhi.
I'm 7 by 5.
Yes, 7 by 5. So that will be 1 plus 2 by 5. That is 7 by 5. Now calculate that for linear triatomic gas. linear triatomic, degrees of freedom are 7. So what is gamma for linear triatomic gas? Yes, Shreya.
Ma'am, 9/7.
9/7. So 1 plus 2/7 is 9/7. And for non-linear triatomic? For non-linear triatomic gas, what it will be? Degrees of freedom are 6. So 1 plus 2/6 is how much?
4/3.
So 1 plus 2/6 is 1 plus 1/3, that is 4/3. So gamma for nonlinear triatomic gas will be 4/3. It will be 4/3. All right, is that clear? Fine. Now there is a law that is called law of equipartition of energy. Otherwise, if we followed the proper method of calculation of gamma, then we would have used this law. This law is called the law of equipartition of energy. So let's do that. The law of equipartition of energy. Law of equipartition of energy. If we take any system, any thermodynamic system also. Yes, Mayank?
Ma'am, can you thoda niche kar do?
Haan ji.
Actually, wo niche wala likha, fir thoda sa niche kar do camera. Actually, fir baad mein niche wala likha, samajh nahi.
Aap theek hai?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Chaliye. Now, let's see. So, law of equipartition of energy means if we take any thermodynamic system, any system, okay, then total energy will be equally distributed among the degrees of freedom. Jo total energy hai, wo degrees of freedom ke beech mein equally distribute hogi, and the energy associated with each molecule per degree of freedom is half k. This law gives the energy associated with each molecule per degree of freedom, half k. ठीक है चलिए लिखिए स्टेटमेंट लॉ ऑफ इक्विपार्टीशन ऑफ एनर्जी स्टेट्स दैट इट स्टेट्स दैट टोटल एनर्जी ऑफ एनी थर्मोडायनेमिक सिस्टम टोटल एनर्जी ऑफ एनी थर्मोडायनेमिक सिस्टम इज इक्वली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड Total energy of any thermodynamic system is equally distributed among its degrees of freedom. Equally distributed among its degrees of freedom and the energy associated with each molecule Energy associated with each molecule per degree of freedom is energy associated with each molecule per degree of freedom is ये लिखिए half kT where k is Boltzmann constant okay k is Boltzmann constant and t is temperature here okay टी इज टेम्परेचर हियर. टोटल एनर्जी ऑफ अ थर्मोडायनेमिक सिस्टम, टोटल एनर्जी ऑफ अ थर्मोडायनेमिक सिस्टम इज इक्वली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड, इज इक्वली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड अमंग इट्स डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम, इक्वली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड अमंग इट्स डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम एंड एनर्जी एसोसिएटेड, एनर्जी एसोसिएटेड with each molecule per degree of freedom is, each molecule per degree of freedom is half kT. That means agar hum ye hai energy associated with one molecule for one degree of freedom yahi hua na. That is half k. So if we say that there are n molecules and there are f degrees of freedom, then total energy of the system would be n f into half k. Total energy of the system would have been n multiplied by f multiplied by half k. Just unitary method लगाया हूँ. इसका मतलब टोटल एनर्जी ऑफ द सिस्टम U इतनी होगी. अगर एक मॉलिक्यूल की एक डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम के लिए हाफ के टी है, तो n मॉलिक्यूल्स के लिए और f डिग्रीज ऑफ फ्रीडम के लिए ये कितनी होगी, एन एफ इंटू हाफ के. सो इफ वी डिराइव गामा बाय प्रॉपर इलेबोरेटेड डेरिवेशन, okay, then we would have used this formula, but now we are not doing it. You just keep the statement of this law in mind, that energy of any system is always equally distributed amongst the degrees of freedom, and for one degree of freedom the energy will be half kT. Accordingly we can calculate the total energy for so many degrees of freedom, all the degrees of freedom. Haan ji.